Good morning, class. Today we are going to begin with the third part of EVS 1 lesson number 21. Right, children? So moving further, a new word, gland. What is gland? An organ that secretes a certain substances, like salivary gland, it secretes saliva. So what is gland? It is an organ that secretes a certain substance inside our body. Digestion. Let us now learn something about the alimentary canal, the digestive organs and their functions. Now this is digestive system. You can see the picture of digestive system. It is on page number 109. You can see page number 109. This is the picture. This is the diagram of digestive system. Now the alimentary canal. The food we eat is digested in our body. That is, substances that can mix with the blood are formed from the food. This process takes place in different parts of a long and flexible tube inside our body. This tube is called the alimentary canal. The upper end of this tube is in the mouth and the lower end is in the anus. Now children, the digestion begins in the mouth. That's why its upper end is in our mouth, the food pipe. It is, even if there is a continuous tube going from the mouth to the anus, the shape of this tube is not the same in all its parts. The shape is different. It differs. Now you can see the food we eat is digested in our body. You know, not digestion of food, where it is digested? In our digestive system. It is not only the stomach, it is not only the small intestine, but many different organs, they work together for the digestion of food. It needs to be digested properly. Now the process of digestion is not a work of only one organ inside our stomach. It begins in the mouth, starts from the teeth. The teeth start chewing the food. When the teeth start chewing the food, saliva is secreted from the salivary glands. It makes the food moist. When the food becomes moist and it is chewed properly, it turns into a soft moist ball. It is what? Turning into a soft moist ball called bolus. It is called bolus, b-o-l-u-s, bolus. Now this process takes place in different parts of long and flexible tube inside our body. It is long, it is flexible, it is not made of bones, it is flexible, right? It is called the alimentary canal. What is it called? The alimentary canal. Now the upper end of this tube is in the mouth. Where is the upper end? It is in the mouth. And where is the lower end? The lower end is the anus. Now, even if there is a continuous tube going from the mouth to the anus, the shape of this tube is not same in all parts of all the parts. Now let's see this. Now this is the diagram. You can see the mouth. You see this mouth. This tube starts here. This is the alimentary canal starting here. So it is, the digestion process starts in the mouth. From here, the food passes through the food pipe, comes here in the stomach. Now this bag-like structure is the stomach, right? Here, the grinding process is done. Here, after the grinding process, the food is sent to the small intestine, where the maximum part of digestion is completed. After completion of maximum portion of the food is sent to the large intestine, large intestine absorbs maximum amount of water and the wastage is thrown out of the body through the anus. Right? You can see this is the anus. So from the mouth till the anus, this is such a long tube which is called alimentary canal. The slurry substance which is formed in the small intestine, like maximum digestion is completed there. From there, the nutritive substances from the food is sent to the blood vessels through its walls. After doing that, the wastage which is left is sent to the large intestine. From large intestine, it is thrown out. First, it gets collected in the rectum and then it is thrown out from the anus. Right, children? Moving further, the different parts of the alimentary canal have different structures and functions. These different parts are called the digestive organs. Certain glands outside the alimentary canal assist the process of digestion. Now, the different parts, the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine, they all are the parts of the alimentary canal. Now, these all parts help in the digesting process. Now, certain glands outside the alimentary canal also assist the process of digestion. Now, digestive organs. The process of digestion begins as soon as the food is taken into the mouth. The teeth, the tongue, and the saliva all help to convert food into a soft, moist ball called bolus, which is easy to swallow. The bolus passes through the esophagus into the stomach. The stomach is shaped like a bag. Here the food is churned. The digestive juices in the stomach bring about some digestive processes. At the same time, some disease-producing germs in the food are also destroyed. The food changes into a thin slurry in the stomach. Then it passes into the small intestine. The small intestine of an adult is about 7 meters long. The digestive juices in the intestine bring about several digestive processes. The secretion of some glands also help the process of digestion. As a result of all these digestive processes, certain substances are produced. These are useful to the body and can mix with the blood. In the small intestine, they are absorbed into the blood. The remaining substances pass into the large intestine. The large intestine of an adult is about 1.5 meters long. Here, much of the water in the remaining substance is absorbed into the body, and what remains are the feces or stools. The feces collect in the rectum for some time. Later, they are expelled from the body through the anus. Okay, children, now let's understand the digestive organs. Now, the process of digestion begins as soon as the food is taken into the mouth. As soon as you start eating, as soon as you start chewing, the teeth start doing their work, that is chewing the food, right? At that time, you can see your mouth becomes watery. Now, where is that water coming from? And what is that water? That is saliva. It is secreted from the salivary glands. As soon as we start eating, the brain gives orders to the salivary glands to secrete the saliva. So, it helps in chewing. When it helps in chewing, it becomes soft, it becomes moist, and after chewing it, it the food converts into a soft moist ball. Now this soft moist ball is called bolus, which is easily swallowed. It does not give us trouble. If it is hard, we can sometimes choke up. So that's why it is used for making it moist. The stomach is shaped like a bag. Here the food is churned. It is churned. It is getting mixed, like it mixed in the mixer, no? How we churn something. It is like a kind of mixer. The digestive juices in the stomach bring about some digestive processes. Some part of the digestion is done in the stomach. At the same time, some disease-producing germs in the food are also destroyed. Some disease-producing germs which are there in the food are also destroyed at that point. Now, the food changes into a thin slurry into the stomach, thin liquid type. It changes into a thin liquid type stomach in the stomach. Then it passes into the small intestine. Now, how is the small intestine? The small intestine of an adult is about 7 meters long. The digestive juices in the intestine bring about several digestive processes. Now, the digestive juices in the intestine produces what? It produces intestinal juices. Intestines produce intestinal juices. Stomach produces gastric juice. Pancreas produce pancreatic juice. Liver produces bile. What does liver produce? It produces bile. Now, the secretion of some glands also help the process of digestion. As a result of all these digestive processes, certain substances are produced. Now, these are useful to the body. Now, these certain substances which are produced are useful. It is of use to our body and can be mixed with the blood. Now, from the walls of the small intestine, it is passed through the blood. Now, in the small intestine, they are absorbed into the blood. Where? In the small intestine. The remaining substance is passed into the large intestine. The remaining substances. Now, the large intestine of an adult is about 1.5 meters long. Here, much of the water in the remaining substance is absorbed in the body. The large intestine absorbs the maximum amount of water. It is 1.5 meters long. Okay, children? Now, the remaining substances is absorbed in the body, and what remains are the feces or the stool. It is the feces or the stool, the wastage thrown out in from the body. Now, these feces are collected in the rectum. For some time it is collected there. Later they are expelled from the body through the anus. The wastage from the body is thrown out from the anus. Now, one thing more, children, you must have heard here. The large intestine of an adult is 1.5 meters long and the small intestine is 7 meters long. So actually the small intestine is not small. Actually it is big, but it is thin. That's why it is called small intestine. Now you can see here, what is this large intestine? It is small. The small intestine is this. Okay. This is the large intestine. This is small intestine. Small intestine is 7 meters long. But it is thin. You can see the thickness of the intestine. That's why it is called large and this one is called small. I hope you all have understood the lesson. So this was end of part 3. We shall continue in the next lecture. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.